Hey guys, so today's video is going to be my November favorites. These are products I have been loving in the month of November, and I have to be honest, I feel like I've been saying this every month, but I don't have that many products to share with you guys today. I don't know what's up with me. I'm dealing with a lot of stuff in my personal life. The past few months have just been filled with so much anxiety and so much stress that has nothing to do with YouTube or have anything to do with work. It's a lot of personal things. So a lot of the times I haven't even been wearing makeup. It's been like a bumpy month, and I feel like it's been that way for a few months now. And I don't know, hopefully things get better, but when I have been wearing makeup, these are the products I have been using. I'm gonna try to make it a point to use a lot more makeup in the month of December and really test out more products. I really feel like I need a change in my life in the sense of like my channel. I wanna do more things. I also wanna incorporate more fashion videos on my channel. Really wanna focus on my channel in 2017. That is a huge goal of mine. I feel like recently I've been letting my personal life get in the way of my YouTube life, and that cannot happen. I don't know. Things have just been really weird for me. But I'm gonna bust out of my funk, and we are gonna talk about my favorite products of November. Happy thoughts, good stuff. So the first thing I want to talk about is actually a mascara that I have been using non-stop. And at first, I didn't like this on my top lashes, but now it's like all I've been wearing. This is the Trish McEvoy High Volume Mascara in Jet Black. I purchased this on Amazon. It was a recommendation from Makeup by Tiffany D here on YouTube. I believe this is like one of her favorite mascaras, and I really wanted to try it because she said it was a tubing mascara, which if you don't know what that is, basically tubing mascaras, they're really cool. They coat your lashes kind of like with a gel consistency. Well, I wouldn't say gel. I don't know how to explain it, but when you go to wash it off, they come off in like little tubes. They look like tiny little spider legs that are just coming off of your lashes, and it makes it so much easier to remove because you don't have all that running black mascara. You don't have a black eye. It's not smudgy. It doesn't go everywhere. It's the best when you want to take it off. It just comes off so easily, and I'm someone who hates to remove mascara. I don't know. Is that a thing? I really really dislike taking my mascara off at the end of the day. But with this mascara, it's so easy. They just come off in little tubes. There's no mess involved. And I actually think it's one of the best, it's the best tubing mascara I have ever tried. A lot of them are really good, but they leave your lashes very natural looking. I like a lot of volume to my lashes, and most tubing mascaras just give me just not enough. I feel like this gives me enough. I'm wearing it on my top lashes today and on my bottom lashes. This is amazing for your lower lash line because it is the tiniest little wand. Look how skinny that is, which makes it so easy to coat your bottom lashes. And I had tried it on my top lashes in like a recent video, and I didn't really like how it looked. But if you really build it up, it can get really, really volumizing, and I really like the look it gives my lashes. I have other mascaras I love more than this, but when it comes to a tubing mascara, this is hands down the best I've ever tried, and I've tried a few brands. It is a little bit pricey, but I do think it's definitely worth the money, especially on days where I'm like, ugh, I don't want to put on that much makeup. I'll put on a little bit of this, and then I'm good because it's just so easy to remove. So I love you, Trish McEvoy, High Volume Mascara in Jet Black. Okay, so my next product is a foundation, which I'm sure you totally saw coming. Ever since I tried this, I have been using it non-stop. This is the LA Girl Pro Coverage High Definition Longwear Illuminating Foundation. I am in the shade Fair. This is the foundation I'm wearing on my face today. I love this foundation so much. The more I wear it, the more I love it. I believe it's only $10, extremely affordable. I love the finish of this. It gives your face a beautiful dewy look, but it's not too dewy. It doesn't look greasy on the skin, but you do want to make sure that you set this foundation down. It is tacky to the touch. It will get everywhere. It will slip and slide everywhere if you don't set it, but I find that when you set it, it still leaves your face looking beautiful and natural. There is nothing I dislike about this, literally nothing. I wish it did last a little bit longer on my skin. It says it's long wearing, and it is. I mean, I get a good like 7 hours out of this, but I wish it just lasted a little bit longer. But honestly, for the price, I cannot complain. It's so good. Concealer blends really nicely on top. I just really truly love this. I love that it's a pump. I mean, it's so good. You can get LA Girl on the LA Girl website, or I think you can also get this brand at certain dollar stores. Don't quote me on that. I would highly recommend this if you have normal to dry skin. I think you would really, really like it. At least, I think you would. I truly love it. And I also used this one. I've only used this one or two times, but I really like it as well. This is the white foundation. This is awesome to mix in with any of your dark foundations, any of your more summer shades. We're now going into winter, and I think that this is such a cool little thing to have because you can just mix it with your summer foundation and make it your winter foundation. And you only have to spend $10. You don't have to go and buy a brand new foundation. And because I like the formula so much, it's like the same formula, I love it. It works really well, blends it in with other foundations. I don't think it really changes the consistency of the other foundations. Manic Panic has a white foundation that I've spoken about in the past that I really like, but I think I might even like this one a little bit more. I have to play around with it more. I've only used it a couple times, but I really, really do like the white one as well. I'm obsessed. I've definitely been loving this. This is like my top love this month. Okay, so now we're going kind of like on the other side of the spectrum in terms of price. My next favorite is a blush that is seriously ridiculously overpriced, especially for what it looks like. This is a blush from the brand Surratt. I'm not exactly sure if that's how you say this. This is the strangest little blush. It comes in like this little flimsy packaging. I mean, look at this tiny thing. It's like, look at this. The packaging is plastic and it just like comes out. You would think this is like a pan that you would throw in a Z palette, but it's not. Like, this is the packaging. It's really weird. I'm not a big fan of this packaging and the fact that it like slides out and it's just kind of weird. It's like, what is this? Like, what is this packaging? This is a $32 blush. I bought this at Sephora, and when I got it in the mail, I was like, what in tarnation is this? But the second I put it on my face, I was like, wow, I love this. I love this color so much. It's the blush I'm wearing on my cheeks. You guys know I like a very muted, toned down blush. This one is in the shade Chaleur. This is such a pretty everyday color. In the pan, it really doesn't look like anything special, but it almost has kind of like a satin finish. And on the cheeks, it kind of gives your face a hair of a glow, a satin look. It doesn't look like a matte, flat, chalky blush. There's like life to this blush. I don't know. It's very, very beautiful. Like, every time I put on makeup, this is the blush I go for. Ever since I bought it, I've been using it so much this month. It's like falling out of this stupid packaging. I hate this brick. I look past the packaging because the color is so beautiful and I really like the finish. I'm sure there's a bunch of colors on the market that look just like this, but there's something special about it. I don't even know how to explain it. Online, it's described as a sun-kissed nude, and I totally agree. You look sun-kissed, but nude. I hate that I love it, but I do. I love this blush. I definitely see it as like my go-to for a really, really long time. If they would just like, you know, not have it look like this, that'd be fabulous. Speaking of beautiful, I have rediscovered something that I haven't used in so long. And if you've been following my channel for a while, you're like, oh my gosh, you still have that? But I do. This is the Physicians Formula Natural Nude Highlighter. I cut mine. This had like a back piece, but I cut it because it didn't fit into my slots. And the only way it would fit into the little slot was if I cut it. So I did. So now it's like broken. But I mean, you could see the mirror. It's, you know, that back piece was doing nothing. Anyway, these highlights have a really weird name because Physicians Formula also has a shimmer strip that doesn't look anything like this. But on the website, this is described as a shimmer strip as well. It's their Shimmer Strip Custom All-in-One Nude Palette for Face and Eyes in the shade Natural Nude. If you want an incredible, beaming, amazing, like out of this world highlight for under $15, this is your guy right here. I believe it's like $13.99. Pretty pricey for drugstore, but this is one of the best highlights at the drugstore, hands down. This is the highlight I'm wearing on my face right now. And I love that you get so many little squares. You can get like a super white, intense highlight, something a little bit more pink, or something a little bit more golden. You have all of that in one. I love this. I pulled this back out to like use in a video, I think, in a tutorial, and I was like, why don't I use this anymore? It has quickly become one of my favorite products ever. I think I even like it more now than I did before. Even if you're not someone who really likes drugstore makeup, you need to try this. The quality is out of this world. Like, if you would have covered this and labeled this as a Becca highlight, I would have thought it was a Becca highlight. Get your hands on this. I think it's really, really amazing, and I think it would work for every skin tone because you go from like this white shade to like a beautiful deep bronze. Ugh. So good. I could talk here for hours about this. It's awesome. My next favorite is really weird, like really, really weird. This is a little like spatula thing from e.l.f. I was actually just on the website to see what this is called, and I had no idea. e.l.f. makes a brush cleaning glove. What? It has 5 stars and it's only 10 bucks. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna buy that after I film this video. Anyway, I can't find this on the freaking website. I just can't go through all these pages right now. We're gonna call it the little e.l.f. spatula. It has this like blue silicone spatula at one end and then like this little weird little brush. Don't exactly know what this is about, but I love this little thing. So as you know, face masks usually most of the time always come in like a little jar, and it's not extremely sanitary to just constantly dip your fingers in there. Even if you wash your hands beforehand, which I totally recommend, but even if you wash your hands, it's your fingers. I don't know, I don't like doing it. Well, this is the perfect little tool for that. I just scoop up some face mask and then I apply it to my skin, and this little silicone thing applies your face mask really easily, really evenly. You get like a perfect thin layer on your entire face and you don't have to dirty your fingers in the process, which I think is a fabulous thing. I have been loving this for months, but I thought it was something I should mention because, I don't know, some of us don't like to put our fingers in face masks, but we also don't wanna use other things. Like, I used to use a regular like foundation brush to apply my face masks, but this works a little bit better. It's really affordable, really good. If you are a face mask applier, like some people don't really do that, but if you're someone who really indulges in a good face mask once or twice a week, I highly recommend you pick this up because it's just a breeze, this little thing. I love it. Okay, so I have three lip products that I have been wearing nonstop. The first one is definitely the thing I have on my mouth. This is the Ofra Longlasting Liquid Lipstick in the shade Tuscany. When I first got this color in the mail, I was like, oh, pretty, a nice mauvey purple. I thought it wasn't gonna be anything special. I've seen this color 100 times before, but for some reason, when I applied it, I fell completely in love with this color. It is one of my I've had a liquid lipstick on my tooth this whole time. It's definitely one of my favorite Ofra liquid lipsticks ever, aside from a certain two, if you know what I mean. I love this color so much. It's kind of like a mauve and a berry color got together and had a love child, and it was Tuscany. I love it so much, and I think it's one of those colors that would look beautiful on literally everyone. Like, literally, I can't think of somebody this wouldn't look good on. Even with a look today, all I did was put on a little bit of eyeshadow and I threw on some mascara and I put this lip on, and I feel good. I love this color. If you're into purples and you're into mauves, I love purples. I spit everywhere. I love purples, I love mauves, but I'm someone who prefers like oranges and rusty red tones, like very warm colors. But this is making me change my mind. I love this shade so much. So I've been wearing that a lot. And I wanted to give a quick shout out to Colourpop's Lippie Stick in the shade Chateau. This is one of their Matte X formulas, which is like a completely different formula from their regular matte lippie sticks. Their matte lippie sticks, like Lumiere, they're matte, but they're not like matte. They have a little bit of moisture to them. These are matte. Like, they're as matte as a lipstick could possibly get. When you're wearing one of these Matte X formulas, they look like liquid lipsticks on the lips. They dry so matte. And before this formula, I thought that you could only get that look with a liquid lipstick, but no. Colourpop proved that you can get that look with a lipstick. I love this color. I used it in a recent makeup tutorial. So beautiful for the holidays. It's a red, but it's like a blackened red. It's like a very, it's like a black cherry. Yeah, it's like a black cherry. Very, very deep, very vampy, but it's eye-catching. It is stunning. It's a little bit hard to apply for me because it's so dark, like so dark. You have to work with it a little bit, but once you do, it looks fabulous. And then the last lip product I wanna talk about is something that I have thrown in my purse. And there are like three lipsticks that live in my purse at all times. Three lip products. It's the Buxom Lip Gloss in White Russian, the Tarte lipstick in Park Avenue Princess. Funny because I've never really mentioned that on my channel, but it's one of my favorite lipsticks of all time. It literally lives in my purse, which is probably why I haven't mentioned it or used it on my channel, but Tarte's Park Avenue Princess lipstick and my ColourPop Lippie Stick in Aquarius. Those three shades, they don't leave my purse. They got a new roommate a couple of weeks ago, and it is the Essence lipstick in the shade Cool Nude. I mentioned this in my favorite affordable fall lipstick video, and when I used it in that video, I was like, oh my gosh, why don't I bust this out again and use it more often? And that's exactly what I did. I have been using it so much. Just on days where all I do is fill in my eyebrows, put on mascara, and put on a lipstick. I don't even bother with concealer. It's been a crazy month, guys. It's been real intense. This color is just so beautiful. It's a nude, but it's a very cool tone nude. It has a little bit of mauve to it, but it's light enough to where it's amazing for every day. It goes with everything. It's not too dark. It's like the perfect shade of a cool tone nude. I don't know, it's really, really amazing. I got this at Ulta and it was like a few dollars. Essence is such an affordable brand. You need to get your hands on it if you're into these tones. You need this lipstick, like you really do. Okay, two more products to share with you and then this video is over. Funny how I said that I didn't have a lot of products to talk about, but I've been here for a while already. My next favorite is something that I didn't think I was gonna like as much as I do. This is the Glamglow Dreamduo Overnight Transforming Treatment. I recently bought this after hearing so many people rave about it. I think I saw a video where Manny was talking about it and I was like, okay, fine, I'm gonna buy that. Because in the past, I haven't been extremely impressed with Glamglow. The only mask I truly, deeply love is the black one. It's like the Tingle Exfoliating one, which apparently is like everybody's least favorite, but that one is my favorite. Danny also really likes the white one, but there's so many dupes for the white one that I don't find that one worth it. Whatever, point is, I haven't been like, oh my gosh, over the moon impressed with Glamglow, but this I actually really, really like. Now, I've only used this 5 times, but I mean, in the 5 times that I've used it, I have been really, really impressed with the results. So it says it's an overnight transforming treatment. Basically, it has 2 different masks or overnight treatments. You have step 1 and then you have step 2. You're supposed to put this one on first, this like creamy white color, and you let that sink in and let it dry for about 30 seconds, and then you go over it with the gray one, and then you go to sleep, and you're supposed to wake up with like very hydrated, beautiful skin. It's supposed to help with your texture and with your dryness. And recently, because of all of the treatments I've been doing to my face, trying to get rid of like the bumps on my skin, it has really, really, really dried out my skin. Like even more than before. If I thought I had dry skin before, louder. And this has helped it so much. Every time I use it, I wake up in the morning and my face almost looks like plumper. It looks way more hydrated, way more smooth. And I mean, it's what I can ask for, because mama has been needing some help in the hydration category. But it is $60, so if I can, you know, maybe try something else that's not as expensive, that'd be great. But besides that, I love this. The price, a little steep, but it just makes my skin look so glowy and luminous the very next day. Okay, so my last favorite is actually this. I love this. This is the Johnson & Johnson's Baby Soothing Vapor Bath. Comforts fussy babies. So as some of you know, I suffer from like really bad migraines, and actually one of you guys commented either on Instagram or Twitter. One of you told me to pick this up because it really helped you with your migraines. So I picked this up and I fell in love with this. I love baths after I've already showered. There's something about sitting in your own, you know, bath water that's a little bit weird, but what I like to do is I'll take a shower, you know, I'll wash my entire body, and then I'll just sit in a bath once I'm already clean, and it really just helps me relax. Like, it really helps me relax. It smells like Vicks Vapor Rub, you know, one of those scents. It kind of like takes over the whole bath, and you're like, you feel like you're in a spa. Especially when I feel sick, like when I feel like I'm getting a cold and my nose is a little stuffy, I'll take a bath with this and it like clears out my congestion. You know, we're babies sometimes and we get fussy. And this is very comforting. It's just amazing. Thank you so much to the subscriber who recommended this for my headaches, because it really has been helping calm me down. If I have a lot of anxiety, if I'm having like a very stressful day, I'll just take a bath with this, and the scent really does like chill me out. The vapor in it just like makes me breathe better. Maybe that's in my head, but I feel like the scent helps me breathe. So yeah, that completes this video. These were products I've really, really been loving in the month of November. It's been a rocky month in terms of like my anxiety. It's kind of coming back pretty strong, like how it was a few years ago. And this month was just not a super makeup-y month for me. I am making it a mission to change that. I need to get out of my funk. I'm so over this, Kathleen. Like this moody, I'm over you. If you had a crappy November, I hope December is way, way better for you. And hopefully in my December favorites, I'll have a crap ton more to talk about. So leave me a comment down below what your favorite product was this month, and maybe I'll check it out if I haven't already. Please leave me recommendations. What do I need to buy? Like, what makeup do I need to try out? Let me know. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you in my next video. Bye. This is a Damn you, postman. Damn all the postmen. Can someone explain the packaging to me though? Like, why would they do this? Like, it's just so weird. Your foundation, no. What your favorite product of the month this was, that didn't make sense. So today's video is going to be my November.